Unfortunately, the clinical trial for FX322, a drug that supposedly could have helped cure sensorineural hearing loss, failed. I am really sad to report that unfortunately, Frequency Therapeutics, the company testing the drug FX322 to cure sensorineural hearing loss, reported on February 13th through a press release that unfortunately, the test to test the drug to see if it would heal sensorineural hearing loss was not a success. In today's video, I'm going to talk about this drug trial, just kind of some of the criteria for qualifications and eventually the results of this failed drug. I have linked the original source in the comments down below. I hope you stick around to the end of this video because I will be sharing some of the company information. The company has decided to pivot since this option didn't work out, and unfortunately their CEO is experiencing some slightly ironic health woes. Stick around to the end. All right, my name is Emily. I have a moderate to severe bilateral, which means both sides, sensory neural hearing loss. However, my hearing loss is a little bit different. It would not be a qualifier to participate in this FX322 study because my sensory neural hearing loss is genetic. In order to participate in this study, individuals needed to be between 18 and 65 years old. They needed to have sensorineural hearing loss due to typically aging. So I wouldn't have qualified to participate in this study. Individuals were also required to have an audiogram to show the severity of their losses. So in order to test whether or not FX322 worked, Frequency Therapeutics set up a study to gauge whether or not people that received this drug could better understand intelligible speech. So one thing that a lot of people don't understand with hearing loss is that we can receive hearing devices and we may be able to hear, but the ability to discriminate or understand what we are hearing is where a real challenge lies. So in order to test this, the scientists set up the study in a way that they would inject the drug FX322-208, it's just another subtitle for the drug, and a placebo into the participant's middle ear. So you have your ear canal, that's considered part of your outer ear. The middle ear is where your malleus, incus, and stapes bones lie up against the eardrum. So they would inject it through the eardrum into the middle ear, and ideally the drug and the placebo would be absorbed by the inner ear, which is where the cochlea lies with the hair cell and the auditory nerve to the brain. This path is where the sensorineural hearing loss manifests itself. Issues with this inner ear and the path to the brain. It's a neurological or sensorineural hearing loss. And so the drug would be injected through the eardrum into the middle ear and be absorbed by the inner ear. Now they did this, they tested the drug and they tested the placebo. They found no statistical difference between people's ability to understand speech based on whether they got the drug or the placebo. If this would have been a successful drug and study, they would have liked to have seen people's scores in their discrimination or speech understanding scores to be significantly higher, statistically significantly higher for those that received the FX322 drug. Unfortunately, that wasn't the case. Now, the good news is of all these people that participated, they saw no negative effects. So that is a good thing that these people don't have adverse negative effects. So therefore, there's just no distinguishable difference. So because there's no benefits of receiving these injections, Frequency Therapeutics pulled the study and pulled funding for a sensory neural hearing loss drug. This includes pulling funding for the testing on FX345, which was another sensory neural hearing loss cure test. So this is a huge bummer for those adults experiencing sensory neural hearing loss. This test gave a little glimmer of hope, and I know that there are so many people that were watching my earlier videos asking for updates. And unfortunately, this is not the news we were hoping with this. Now that said, we are not left empty-handed. We still have hearing devices. So I encourage you, if you have sensorineural hearing loss and you have not tried a hearing device, try one out. Not just an amplifier, you need a hearing aid. You need a high-end brand name hearing aid. These devices are smart. They are able to increase the sound pitches and volumes of what your hearing loss and you need. Have it fit by a proper audiologist and hearing professional and see if it works for you. In the US, we have 30-day, no obligation, money back guarantees on hearing aids. Now, I will say 30 days is not enough time to get used to a hearing aid, but at least try it out. All right, so let's talk about Frequency Therapeutics just a little bit. Because they are no longer focusing on sensorineural hearing loss drug cures, they are reappropriating spend to the remyelination of multiple sclerosis. So they are working with proteins in vitro to help repair muscle tissue for people with multiple sclerosis. So it's unfortunate that that money had to be reallocated, but because the drug just wasn't working, it makes sense as a business decision. And last but not least, I hinted about this at the beginning of the video. Thanks so much for watching through this video. Here is the end. The Frequency Therapeutics CEO, David Lucchino, I hope I'm pronouncing that right. If not, I apologize. But CEO Lucchino has unfortunately been hospitalized for bacterial meningitis. I mentioned earlier in my video that this is slightly ironic because meningitis is one of the biggest causes of sensorineural hearing loss. Did you know that 5 to 35% of bacterial meningitis patients come down with sensorineural hearing loss as a side effect of this sickness? Yeah. So I just really hope for his sake that this CEO, David Lucchino, doesn't have this adverse side effect of bacterial meningitis. And if he does, it's just unfortunate that the company he works for has just decided to discontinue any research for a cure for sensorineural hearing loss. I find that so interesting. Like, what are the chances? But the fact that he was hospitalized and it sounds like a bad case just from what I read. And it will be interesting to see if he comes down with sensorineural hearing loss. About 4% of bacterial meningitis patients have a profound sensorineural hearing loss because of the severity of either the infection or just the impact on their inner ear. So, what do you think about this? I do think that some people could be like, oh, that's like karma. I do think that some people could say like, no, it's just a chance. I personally just think that like, I've always thought everything happens for a reason. This is just like wild though. I can't even call it a coincidence. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comments below and let me know what you think about this video. I would also love to hear in the comments below. I hope you're all doing well. If this video is disappointing to you, because I know it is for so many of us, remember that you are not alone. There are so many people with hearing loss. And in fact, it is estimated that by 2050, 2.5 billion, with a B, billion, people will have some degree of hearing loss. Crazy. So you are not alone. Remember, I have it too, and we are gonna get through this. Just treat your hearing loss, get answers as much as you can, and then once you have your answers and you've addressed it, focus on the good in life, and that will help you replace the bad and the negativity and feel better. If you haven't already, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. I look forward to making more great videos for you. Stay strong, stay amazing, and have a great day.